Bob, we're nearing that magic moment, the final of the men's 200 meters, the world record Pietro Mannella, the time of 1972. He was here, appearing in his fifth Olympics as a sprinter at age 36, and he finished fourth in his heat with a time of 21:10. Carl Lewis holds the Olympic record of 1980, and he set that at the Los Angeles Games in 1984. And Carl also holds the American record of 1975. And I think that Carl learned a lesson from Edwin Moses. He noticed that he had his measuring stick out, setting his blocks on the exact way that he wanted them. We saw Edwin do that. I've never seen Carl do that before, although he may, you know, he may well have done that before. Now we are live. Carl Lewis going for his record third goal again. He has the 100 and the long jump. And now going at 200 meters. The lane assignments. In lane one, from France, the surprise silver medalist at the World Championship, Gio Quinierve. In lane two, the Pac-10 champion, Cal Berkeley, Canada, Atlee Mahorn. Lane three, Carl Lewis, USA. Lane four, Robson da Silva. He was fourth in the 87 World Championships. He's from Brazil. In the fifth lane is Linford Christie of Great Britain, and he now has the silver medal in the 100 here. Lane six, Joe DeLoach of the United States. He beat Carl, edging him out at the U.S. trials in Indianapolis. In lane seven, Bruno Marie Rose of France. And in lane eight, Michael Ross-West of Great Britain. Joe DeLoach.
Joe DeLoach is the man who can beat Carl Lewis over 200 meters. I don't think anyone else in the field can, but this man is in the right spot to do it. He's in lane six. He's on the outside. He can't see Carl Lewis. He is going to have to run the turn as fast as he possibly can. He also has to be ahead coming off the turn, because I think Carl, down the straightaway, will gain.
Linford Christie of Great Britain, now with a silver medal, and at the 100, he is in lane five.
Historically, Linford Christie has been a little better at 100 meters than 200 meters, but he ran so well in the final. He was very close to Carl Lewis in the 100-meter final. So if he's in top form, he'll be a threat.
And updating you, no one has ever won two golds in the 100 before in the Olympics. Carl has now done it, nor had it happen in the long jump, and he has now done it. An Olympic champion has never repeated in 200. So we're set to go. The final. Men's 200 meters. Carl Lewis going for his third goal. It's a fair start.
And Carl's got a great start.
He has already closed down on Robson da Silva. Carl Lewis does not have a world record. Joe DeLoach outside at six. It is DeLoach in front of Lewis. It is Lewis and DeLoach. It is DeLoach and Lewis. DeLoach! Joe DeLoach of the United States. Carl Lewis with the silver. Robson, the silver, Brazil, finishes third. Training mates in Houston. An Olympic record, 1976.
Joe DeLoach cannot believe it either, but I think if you watched him in the semifinal, how easily he ran down the last 50 meters, how light he was on his feet, as we saw before. Carl Lewis gave it everything he had here. He ran that first turn as well as anyone I've ever seen, and you could see in lane three, he was really out well. He was out better than anyone else. But if you look at Joe DeLoach in lane six, really accelerates off the turn. Ran the turn much better than he did in the semifinal heat. Right here, they're all even, I think. But just as they start to come off the turn, Joe DeLoach accelerates off the turn a little better than Carl Lewis. And now it is just man against man. Carl Lewis just isn't getting the turnover. You can see his knees aren't coming up quite as high. And Joe DeLoach is just able to hold on a little more. Carl was straining just a bit more, and that's the margin.
Joe DeLoach, Carl Lewis, Robson da Silva.
And Joe DeLoach isn't looking anywhere except right at the finish line. This man has natural talent. Carl Lewis does, but this man is equal to Carl Lewis in natural talent. And today was the day that he really realized it.
And the wind is all right. Carl helping recruit DeLoach for the University of Houston.
And Carl Lewis ran very well down the straightaway, did everything he could, ran as fast as this man could possibly run today. He just got beaten by a better runner. He looks over a little bit at the finish, but he waited.
The thing that I notice with Carl is so often we're so used to seeing Carl hit that other gear with about 50 meters to go and pulling away. It didn't happen in Indianapolis. It did not happen here. This is very much the same type of race that happened in Indianapolis, where Carl just seemed to run out of gas, could not shift into that overdrive gear that he has.
Isolated on Carl Lewis.
Carl runs the turn very well. This is a naturally gifted athlete who has taken that gift and refined it. And he made no mistakes in this race. Don't think that he did something to lose this race. He did everything he could. But he just was lacking that conditioning in the last 40 meters.
Perhaps all of the hundreds and the long jump and the 200s taking its toll, but let's not take anything away from Joe DeLoach. He runs a 19.76. That is a new Olympic record and an American record officially, 19.75. Even better. Joe DeLoach continuing to celebrate the gold medal in the men's 200 meters. And there is Carl Lewis with the silver. And the official results. Joe DeLoach with a 19.75, an Olympic record, equaling the American record. Carl Lewis running a very fine 19.79. Robeson De Silva coming in third. And Linford Christie just out of the medals. Meanwhile, Joe DeLoach and Carl Lewis, the celebration continues. And we'll be back to the Olympics right after these messages from your local station.
A 200-meter race, Joe DeLoach and Carl Lewis. And Joe, training with Carl obviously has paid off tremendously for you. Congratulations on the win.
Thanks. Yes, it has. Carl has been an inspiration for me throughout this whole year. I think he's definitely made a difference because we've really had some great training. Coming into this meet, we've really trained, I can say, harder than we probably ever have. We were definitely in peak form, so we felt like we would run well.
Aren't you glad you recruited him?
Well, yeah, I am. But more so than that, more so than just for Houston, but for America. I mean, this is a tremendous thing that's happened. We had a sweep in the long jump, and we did two places in the 100, now two in the 200. That's probably the best thing about it. The United States is able to do well, and if the recruiting can do well for Houston and America, that's great.
All right, take a look at the race, and we pick it up at the start. And, Joe, tell us what your thoughts were as you were coming out of the blocks.
Coming out of the blocks right there, I got out pretty well. I caught the guy in the lane ahead of me right there about 30 meters out, so I knew I was in good position. I didn't know where the rest of the field was, but I just wanted to accelerate the whole turn and come out of it ahead or at least even and stay maintained and stay relaxed down the home stretch. Right there, I was beginning to feel Carl.
All right, Carl, tell us about here you are the last 50, 60 meters.
Well, right here is where I started to feel some fatigue, but I felt that technically I ran the best race I possibly could have. And just right at the end, Joe had the more strength right at the end, and that was a difference.
This is another feather in your cap and your efforts to try to get Joe on the 4x100 team. Do you think that maybe your point has proved a little bit more today?
Well, I don't really think, like I said all along, I don't think it's been a personal thing to get Joe or anything. It's just that we all know and America knows and now the world knows how well Joe's running. And if our efforts to have the best members on the team are there, then obviously Joe's proven he should be on it.
All right, guys, thank you very much. Back to Charlie Jones.
He makes a strong point and is covered it with gold. Joe DeLoach, Carl Lewis, finishing 1-2, Robeson De Silva with the bronze. Let's go to Bob Costas. Bob?